Just noticing the resonance of the chanting, perhaps in your body, perhaps in the room. Noticing how the goodness of those words acts as a kind of container to hold you, to uplift you, to connect you with the goodness in your heart. And allow your heart to rest in that goodness. Virtue that's not only an abstinence, but that's also a positive. The qualities of harmlessness and compassion that you try to embody. That motivates your speech. And your actions, your interactions. And perhaps connecting with something you've done or said, or even an attitude you felt in your heart of compassion, of support, of kindness towards yourself or towards another person today. Even if it was just a smile. And allowing that to bring a mental smile to your being. See if you can notice a sense of contentment and maybe satisfaction that you know your life is on the right path, on the right track. Or that you're wishing, you're trying with sincerity to align your life in the right direction. Just really notice the beauty of that. Something very extraordinary. So as we start to come in contact with the inner world, make sure you have two tools at hand. The first one is awareness, and the second one is kindness that goes along with that awareness. As So awareness has no colour, but the kindness infuses that awareness with a particular hue. So that everything that comes in contact with your mind, everything you're aware of, is met and held with warmth and kindness. So you're making friends with every experience. Whether it's tiredness in the body or aching legs, sore knees or back, whether it's just the feeling of weight or pressure, perhaps on the bottom, seated on the chair or on the ankles, come in contact with your own body. And as you come in contact with the body, notice if you take this body to be who you are, or who you take yourself to be. Are you able to observe the body as a part of nature? Which doesn't belong to you, which is not under your control. And yet regard the body with respect, with curiosity, as though you were the student of your own body. Without claiming it as your own, just seeing what it has to teach you. Made up of earth element, water element, air and fire element. Which element is you? Or does the body simply belong to nature? trying to control or own this body. Just letting it manifest in its own way. Relaxing into the experience of body. As the mind makes contact with the body, you will notice some feeling or the other. Maybe some feelings are pleasant. Others are unpleasant. And even others are not really pleasant or unpleasant. Maybe somewhere in between, perhaps not distinct. If you find yourself becoming tense around any feeling or clinging to any feeling, see if you can relax that attitude, understanding that these feelings are changing constantly and none of them belong to you. Just a play of nature. See see if this understanding brings greater acceptance, perhaps more peace, more contentment with every feeling you experience. Not owning the feelings, but treating them with great respect, with curiosity, as though you were here to learn from them. Now maybe noticing your mental world, any thoughts or perceptions, perhaps of liking or not liking. Perhaps any reaction to the body or to the feeling. Perceptions that you'd rather not have, or perceptions that you enjoy. Do these really belong to you? Or are they too just the effects of causes, the product of whatever you've been doing, the way you were brought up? Noticing what happens when you identify with your mental world. What happens when you can understand that too as the play of nature, rising and passing, rising and passing, subject to conditions, subject to fading away. Allowing nature to manifest, and in its own time to cease, without clinging to any experience as me, mine, or a self. Freeing that would be. Before we end the meditation, I'd like to invite you to reconnect with the qualities of warmth, of kindness, bringing that sort of awareness to your whole experience. As though you were the Buddha looking upon yourself with a gentle smile, with compassion, non-judgment, and total acceptance. Just smiling as nature manifests, without any need to judge, to hold on, or to own. Maintaining this kind awareness, I'll ring the bell 3 times, and at the end of the 3rd ringing, you can open your eyes. Bringing the same attitude of kindness and gentleness toward each other, towards everybody in this room.